a really simple 10-step meditation practice for those of you who want to get much more attuned to your sense of inner and outer experience during your meditation practice. So this is Ian, and I am one of the lead content creators at mindfulmarketplace.com. And today I'm going to walk you through this very simple heuristic, a shortcut. It's almost like a template for guaranteeing you can really take your meditation practice to the next level. I know that a lot of people who are in this limited community that we have here are identifying as empaths or healers or people who are really spiritually sensitive or even emotionally sensitive. And I think this is going to be a perfect practice in particular for you. So I'm going to walk you through the underlying framework, and then I'm going to give you a series of written exercises as well that you can incorporate into your daily practice, and I think you're going to see instant results. So the first step is setting an intention, and the way we frame intention is quite different than, you know, many other meditation practices may. And what I refer to intention as in the service of something. So before you begin your practice, you set your intention to be in the service of, let's say, compassion or wisdom or, understanding or connection. Whatever it is, you set an intention to be in the service of something that you want from your practice. The next step is attention, and this is the spotlight of awareness. You are going to be aiming your awareness in a specific direction. So attention is the spotlight of awareness. Next step is, where do you feel it? Location, right? So it's intention, attention, now location. Where do you feel it? And in most cases, at least in the practices that we're teaching here in the beginner community, are spaces in your body. So you want to direct your attention to a location in your body. Let's say your heart center. It could be your feet. It could be the back of your knees. It could be the back of your head. It doesn't matter. The important thing is to get really attuned to the location where you are aiming the spotlight of your awareness. Sensation, step four. What does it feel like, right? So what does it feel like when you direct your attention to a location in your body? The bottom of your feet, your heart, your knees, your head. What does that feel like? Get really, really, really attuned again, or attentive to that sensation. Next step five is concentration. Now you want to really get as close as possible to that sensation, right? So if you're feeling it in your heart, like a metta or a loving kindness practice, you want to get really, really close to the sensation by dint of using the powers of your concentration. This gets really, really blissful very quickly. It can feel really good. The sensations start to get tingly. You're going to start to feel a little buzzy. And it's really, you know, there are practices that are designed just to tune this up because they feel so good. So again, intention, attention, location, sensation, and now concentration. All right, the next step is visualization. And this is particularly good for those of you who are particularly empathic, or you're really visual people. Your imagination, let's say, is super rich. So I want you to really get close to you're close to the sensation by virtue of the concentration that you're bringing to it. Now I want you to see what appears in the canvas of your consciousness, right? So do you see something? Do things appear to you? What does it look like, right? So for me, when I do this practice, oftentimes these images will pop into my head that, you know, start to, that surprise me, that take the shape and the texture of the practice, right? So when I'm bringing, so the sensation with the appropriate amount of concentration, this visualization practice will give me visuals or images, or I'll see objects. Things will appear that are often quite surprising in my field of awareness. The next step is evaporation. What remains when everything above disappears, right? And this is a crucial move for a more advanced practice that we're going to get into in a couple moments. In just a very rudimentary way, you can only communicate so much of this in this sort of format. But the evaporation piece is when you just let it all go and you let all of this just disappear into this space that you occupy in the world, right? So everything just kind of disappears and only pure sensation remains, right? You just, you become the space in which everything is appearing in the world, right? And there's no inner, there's no outer, there's no subject, there's no object, there's no you looking out into the world and seeing things or seeing objects even in your awareness. It's just space. And this is very esoteric and it can be quite difficult to explain using language, but if you do this practice with this framework, you will have that experience, and it's very, very cool. Okay, so this is where we get a little bit more esoteric, and I'm just going to end this in a moment or two after giving you the basic instruction. So the next phase, or the second tier of this practice, is what I call sense syncing, and essentially it incorporates three different modules. One is deep listening, one is expanding awareness, and one is sound separation. And essentially what you want to do in this part of the practice is, first, as you're in this evaporation stage, right, when you're just really letting everything go and just feeling like formless, like your body isn't even there, you just want to start to gently expand your awareness. And essentially what you're doing here is just allowing this space to grow, right? The space which is you, right? But it's a formless space. You're letting this awareness grow and flow and extend beyond your local consciousness, right? So you're now moving beyond the seat that you're sitting in or the bed that you're lying in, wherever this practice is being done, and you're allowing your awareness to expand. The next thing that you want to do is deep listening. So you want to allow yourself to sink into the space of sound, right? And essentially what this does is it allows you to, as you're moving your awareness, or as you're letting your awareness kind of grow and flow and go outside of the space that's local to you now, you want to get as close as you can to what you hear, right? So it kind of comes back to that whole concentration and you know, practice that we mentioned a couple tears up. You want to get really, really close to whatever it is that's arising in the field or the space of sound. And then the next piece after that is what I call sound separation. And then you simply want to see if you can parse out or notice the nuance of what appears in the sound sense, in the hearing sense. So as you're trying to get this deep listening kind of practice online, right, as you're, all this is happening, you want to see if now you can notice simple, subtle distinctions in the field of sound. And what really happens, what really gets interesting, is you get super close to every sound that impinges on your eardrum, right? You feel the sense of, you notice everything exactly as it pings or pops or arises in your field of awareness, and simultaneously you can hear each separate sound, each separate impingement, in a very different, nuanced way. And it becomes a very exciting, very cool practice of expanded awareness. And this sense syncing piece, and I'm not really going to get too far into this here because it's a more advanced practice, is when you start moving from the sound the space of sound, into the space of sights, and then into the space of tactile touch and taste. And essentially, you are going to get really, really immersed in each specific space, whether it's sound, sight, touch, and taste. And all this starts to really come online in this incredibly exciting way, and you start to realize like how much of your ordinary consciousness is so limited and winnowed and trimmed down to exclude so much of the magical and just really beautiful experience that is available to all of us if we just let our attention, you know, kind of play with this exercise. And again, for those of you who are looking for some sort of, you know, correlate in the, you know, kind of wisdom traditions, there is a really, I think it's a, from maybe a talk given by the Buddha, or it's a very common refrain in Buddhist and even some Hindu circles, but you'll hear this in the hearing, just the hearing, in the seeing, just the seeing, in the smelling, just the smelling, in the tasting, just the tasting, right? So you're just allowing yourself to become really, really immersed in just the one single sense at a time, and really exploring what that feels like to just see, to just be hearing. So in the hearing, only the heard. You're not you hearing, it's just sound. In the seeing, just the seen. You're not seeing, it's not you seeing something, it's just sights appearing in this space. And again, you know, in the tasting, just the, you know, just the taste, right? You're just tasting, you're just really enmeshed, immersed, and sort of entranced by this sensation of taste. Really, really a lot of fun to do, and it can take your practice in some amazing and exciting directions, right? Whatever appears in the canvas of consciousness, that, right, that is what you explore in this practice. Okie doke. So I hope this has been helpful. If you're interested in learning some more about this, send us an email, hi@mindfulmarketplace.com. We also have a private community where we're going to be discussing these sorts of practices and many others, and giving you some worksheets and scripts. Feel free to send us an email as well, hi@mindfulmarketplace.com, if you'd be interested in joining us there. And if you have any comments, as always, I'd love to hear them. Thanks so much, and have a great day.